If women as a whole withheld sex before marriage, would we be better as a society?
Yes,
by far.
You would respect us more.
You would also have like better men too.
Mm-hmm.
You would have better families, better structure, and I think that's what's important. And I think like God provided us with that structure, and that's why I believe there's spiritual warfare everywhere.
Do you think that we control a lot more than we think with our ability to give or withhold sex as women?
Yes.
You just watched a conversation from Turning Point USA's Cuteservatives Roundtable. And I should note that even though they're having a discussion about sexual activity, some of the people included in that roundtable are still in high school. But as you can tell, the conversation went to some pretty weird and dark places. And if you're not familiar with Alex Clark, this brief clip will give you a pretty good idea of what her beliefs are. Let's take a look.
Now here's the spiciest take and we're gonna wrap up. Are y'all ready? I believe that a lot of mothers in the 70s who desired freedom and flexibility or who didn't necessarily have a support system were oblivious to the fact that the solutions presented to them as safe, liberating, or harmless were anything but. And one of those solutions was daycare. Just got real uncomfy. Did you feel that shift?
And she claims that people didn't like that speech because it was boring. Just one more clip and then we'll kind of discuss the topic at hand.
I did a lot of like parenting speak. I talked about daycare and things like that in my speech. So I mean, totally, I won't be offended. But do you guys find that stuff interesting being non-parents, or is it kind of like, eh, I'm not there yet, I'm not really that interested?
I loved it.
No, I loved everything. Like I want to be a good mom one day, and I feel like you need to like learn now in order to become a mother.
Because the mainstream media said in attacks on me based on that speech that you guys who are not mothers yet, the mainstream media, when they attacked me, they said that nobody in the audience cared that I was talking about things like, hey, things you should know whenever you become a mother, or things to consider when it comes to parenthood and things like that. They said everybody was bored.
Yes, bored. That is a good word to describe how I'm feeling right now. Okay, look, conservatives have a problem attracting young women to vote for them. So I think that this is their attempt to appeal to young women. There are tons of young women who look forward to getting married, starting a family, being moms. Some of them might want to be stay-at-home moms, which I think is admirable. I celebrate it, I support it. But I want to support it through policies that make it easier for households to live and thrive on a single income. And that discussion doesn't come up at all. The fact that most households depend on dual income, mother and father, mother and father, whatever it is, whatever the makeup is, two people need to work in order to afford the housing, the food, you know, the expensive cost of living that Republicans love to complain about, but simultaneously pretend like it doesn't exist whenever the nuclear family culture war narrative from them comes up.
Yeah, so I watched a bunch of those videos and first of all, there's things that are traditional conservative values that I don't agree with, but is inoffensive. So they say, oh, we believe in God and these are God's rules. So yeah, it's a free country, go ahead. They say that they don't, you know, they're gonna save themselves from marriage. God bless, no problem. And they believe in traditional roles. It's a free country. That's not the issue at all. But there's three things that they emphasized. The person leading the conversation is pushing in a certain direction and then getting reaction back. And there was three things that they were going for. Number one was don't go to college. And I thought, huh, that's interesting. She pushed that really hard. She's like, now going to college is kind of a waste, right? And a couple of them that were going to college, oh, I learned more from Turning Points USA than I did for professors. Oh, college is a waste. Oh, college is terrible.
I'm like, a good sign.
What's that?
Not a good sign.
Yeah.
I wouldn't brag about that.
Yeah, and no, I wouldn't either. And so then the second thing they pushed is not really, you gotta obey men, right? That's if you're a trad wife and your job is to serve the man and in the traditional ways, etc. Interesting, okay. And then the third one is what they're really driving at. Get married right away. So If you're a woman, don't career, forget it. College, forget it. Just get married and listen to your husband. So the listen to your husband, you were kind of familiar with. But now there is active, and we've shown it to you in Fox News clips, Jesse Waters, Greg Gutfeld, Turning Point USA. They're all driving in the same direction. Why? Why all of a sudden propaganda to get these women married right away? I'll give you the polling that shows you why. We go to Politico, and they're quoting a CNN poll. And according to that exit polling, 72% of women between the ages of 18 to 29 voted Democratic in the House races nationwide, compared to 26% of young women who voted for Republicans. So I'll leave it there, you can see the rest as well. But 72 to 26 is a massive blowout. And when you look at married women, the number closes. It doesn't close all the way, but it closes. So what Republicans have realized is our problem is single women. And we've got to get them married right away so they could become Republicans. Now, that's not really how it works, but in their thick-headed ways, they think, well, we've got a demographic problem. If we get them, move them to the other demographic and get them married, and they'll become trad wives and then immediately vote for us. I don't think so, brothers and sisters, but that is the whole point of this. Do you know, I mean, look, I don't know that this is exactly right because I don't see their internal books, but the reporting is that Turning Point USA gets $80 million a year.
Jeez.
That's not in revenue, that's not from grassroots, that's just from billionaire donors. Why do billionaire donors want all these women to get married right away? Is it because they're all like the most religious people in the world? Maybe some of them, but I think more likely is no, they want to move those numbers so they can get Republicans elected so they can get tax cuts.
Well, corporations are certainly concerned about the lower birth rate in recent years. That, by the way, I mean, a lower birth rate does translate to economic issues in the future. I actually agree with that. But the solution isn't to pressure people to change their social values or to engage in relationships that might not make them happy, or marriages that might not make them happy, or have kids that they might not be ready for. The solution is to create an environment in which people feel empowered and financially stable enough to enter these marriages and have children. Having kids is so expensive. It's so expensive, right? I'm not like one of these like lefties who's like, oh, I'm worried about climate change, that's why I don't wanna have kids. No, it's expensive. And if you live in a society that requires a dual income household and you have to work, but you also have this situation in which childcare is out of reach, expensive, unaffordable, what do you do? Where do you put your kids? Look, I'm gonna say, at one point in my childhood, my family was not doing well and my mom needed to make money, okay? And so I was like 8 years old, they couldn't afford childcare. So in the summer, I stayed home alone with my brother. She had no other choice. That is not a good option. But I'm sure that there are tons of mothers out there who, because they can't afford childcare, because we live in this economic situation, have no other choice but to do that. Okay, and I feel for them. So again, it's very similar to, you know, I remember there was like a big debate back in the day about like, oh, the population, we're gonna be overpopulated. What are we gonna do about overpopulation, right? I don't know, what do you suggest we do? You can't, are you gonna do a one child policy in China? That ended up being a complete and utter disaster. What you can do is educate people about what their options are to have protected sex and make birth control readily available to people so they can protect themselves and not have unwanted pregnancies, right? Same thing goes for family formation, increasing the birth rate. You can't force people to have kids or force people into entering marriages that they don't want to enter. But you can create a situation in which they feel comfortable and financially stable enough to do so.
So why do corporations and rich Republican donors want basically worried about lower birth rates and hence want higher birth rates? One is what Anna mentioned, supply and demand. If you don't have enough demand for the jobs that you're posting, you're gonna have to pay more, and they don't wanna pay more. The second reason is, well, if we don't have enough people that were already born here, we're gonna need more immigrants to come into the country. And a lot of rich Republicans don't want immigrants that don't look like them. So this is a double whammy for them. So that's why they're paying $80 million a year for this propaganda. Now the good news is it ain't gonna work. Okay, Charlie Kirk used to give speeches on college campuses. They thought they were gonna convince college kids through their brilliant oratory. It didn't work at all. The numbers went down, so he changed his scam. And now he's running this grift and it's going in this direction. Look, I got a young daughter. What do I want for my daughter? I want agency so that she is in control. She knows what her options are and she makes the option that is best for her. And so forcing her into an old school role that benefits some other dude is not what I'm interested in, okay? And making her go to work or do anything else is also not what I'm interested in. I want to empower her to make her own choices. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.